Hello Internet, this is Oscar Valise. While I try to be as accurate as possible in these videos, I do sometimes make mistakes. In this video, we'll correct some of those. Let's start with Newton's method. In my equation for finding square root, that negative sign should be a plus. Thank you to user aftabgoinguni for pointing this out. It really does help when you show your work, which let's do right now. When we plug in the function x squared minus a into Newton's method, we can make that first x term match the denominator, and then combine the two fractions, which we can then perform a subtraction. Afterwards, we can break that up and factor out a half, leaving us with this equation for square root. And yes, it is a plus. Now let's move on to Newton fractals. The error here is in the derivative for the arctangent. It should just be 1 over 1 plus x squared. This error is only in the slides, it's not in the actual programming or numerical example. Moving on to Newton bisection hybrid. In the bracket size reduction test, I used delta x, but numerical recipes used delta x old. Thank you to user Martin Stu for pointing this out, and while it is a mistake, I don't think it's necessarily wrong. Here's what I mean. Deciding whether or not to use delta x old versus delta x comes down to two scenarios. The first is if Newton's method is behaving poorly, it could just be one bad iteration. So just wait and see, let it do another iteration and use delta x old. Scenario two says if it's slow right now, why expect the next iteration of Newton's method to be fine? Force a bisection to speed things up. It really is a glass half full, half empty kind of mindset, so either could be valid. Going on to Halley's method, there's a few errors here. First, there's a typo in Christopher Wren's name. He has a W. Then, in the x cubed minus x squared minus x minus 1 example, I used a starting value of negative 2, but I wrote 2. So it should look like this. There's an even larger error, though, in that the first derivative of that function is actually equal to 15. Not 16. Thank you user Tim Dud for pointing this out. When I looked over the documentation for this example, I realized I'd forgotten a minus 1 in the first derivative. This does mean that the numerical results are actually different, as are the graphs. Here's what the iterations should look like, and are presented visually like this. Notice still that Newton's method is still doubling back on itself. And the last error we'll go over is in cubic splines. For this slide, users Derzer Arsad and Kern C pointed out that I'm actually missing some constraints. It should look like this, going through the first and third point. As always, thank you for watching and for letting me know when I have mistakes in videos. If there's an idea that you'd like to suggest, or a bug you find in my programs or videos, you can let me know in my GitHub repository. I have instructions on how to do this in my 2500 subscriber video. Again, thank you for watching.